Back in the show, Bryan Alvarez here, Wrestling Observer Live. Mike Sempervivi, also of WrestlingObserver.com. Ratings are in for AEW's Countdown to Double or Nothing special that aired on Friday night. Special, hour long and began at 10 Eastern, averaged 344,000 viewers on TNT. Ranked 51st on cable for the night in the 18 to 49 demo with a 0.10 rating. So actually, despite the 344,000 viewers as compared to the 600,000 that NXT draws, it actually has beaten probably six episodes of NXT in terms of 18 to 49. The countdown for the February Revolution pay-per-view averaged 383,000 viewers. So this was barely down from that one, 10% down. And that special aired directly after a live broadcast of Dynamite on Wednesday. So quite frankly, this number is more impressive than the number before the February pay-per-view. The February show, a 0.14 in 18 to 49. So this was down 30% from that. But it finished 61st for the night in 18 to 49. So the point of all of this is, we don't have numbers at this moment. But as I noted in the opening segment, based on the streaming numbers and the early buy numbers and the countdown numbers, it appears very, very likely that even at a $50 price tag or $59 or whatever it was, in the middle of a pandemic, in an empty arena, this show did very well for AEW. It's looking like it did about what some of the previous shows have done. So that on the heels of UFC doing 700,000 buys for, I don't want to say a nothing pay-per-view, but those are John Jones numbers for a non-John Jones pay-per-view. I mean, it looks like what everybody, or what Dana White at least, and some others have speculated, people are dying for some live sporting entertainment. It looks like that's the case. And that's with like 30% unemployment in this country. Still, it looks like they did a very, very strong number at $55 or whatever it was a pop. So that's the numbers, and I guess we'll see the follow-up tonight on AEW.
Hey, with the unemployment like that, in some ways, you know, you need the distraction even more, you know, and I know what you're saying about the price tag and everything and going forward. You know, that's still going to be a big thing, especially when everything starts to come back. We're starting to see, well, if, for example, in Nevada now that, you know, there are some things that are still closed, but gyms are open, and the UFC is going to be running what it would be UFC 250, since UFC 249, I believe, is coming up in 2 weeks. It would be UFC 250 that's going to be taking place there, and that's going to be on pay-per-view. Obviously, WWE is running. We're going to start seeing more and more open up and start, and more drag on money, more drag on people's time, and there's going to be people that will be going back to work as things open up. So we'll have to see what the actual aberrations are when it comes to AEW and everything, really when it comes to everything and how people spend their money. It's all uncharted territory for right now, so we'll have to see how things shake out. Will things go back to a level they were at for AEW after this? Was it, you know, it's just there's a lot of question marks we don't know about. We're not really going to know exactly where we are until some hindsight actually takes place, because I'm not entirely sure that these numbers, like everything else, I'm not sure exactly what they mean right now. If it's just a captive audience, if it's just a, you know, benefit of everything, you know, good karma all happening at one time, who knows?
It means,
you know,
people are watching shows is what it means.
It is, and people are hungry right now, but also, great, that's now. Now, for the next one, will it matter? We'll have to see. You know, will the next UFC do that well? We'll have to see. I mean, again, we know at least for the first one, and that's no surprise at all. I mean, look how people responded to Korean baseball showing up on ESPN. People were losing their minds. They're going to stay up all night and watch Korean baseball just to try to get, you know, some baseball. But once, you know, the majors start coming back, is the interest going to be there for Korean baseball? Of course not. So, you know, people's time is going to start getting pulled away and everything too. But for sure, at least to be the first out there and to have your first show back, which essentially is what the UFC and AEW did. They did a hell of a job.